Good evening, everybody. Good morning, good afternoon, hello. Today, we're looking at the next slide, which is slide 29 in the series about crises. And this is the risk factor slide of the IRP 2010 version 8. IRP, the Integrated Resource Plan, which is the resource plan for the next 10, 20, 30 years. It gets updated approximately every 5 to 8 years, although some people think it should be updated more often. I think every 5 years is enough. And this was 2010, and you can see it was the version 8 that we're looking at, and there was still the final version after this. But the version 8 one had quite a lot more things in it than the final version, and I was actually quite upset when they took out a lot of information out of the final version. So let's just look at this version. I had this table 37 of risk factors of different kinds of energy. So no risk, if there's a no risk project, the risk factor is zero, the cost assumptions, the scoring is zero, lead time assumptions zero, security of supply risk zero, operational risks zero. So what zero means is no risk. So if we don't do a project, there's no risk, there's no cost, there's no lead time, it happens instantly, there's no security of supply problem because there's no problem and there's no operational. So if we do a project that has no risk, which is even whatever project you do, there's always a slight amount of risk. Even if you install an air conditioner or a pool pump, there's always a risk that maybe it's dead on arrival or something. But do we know the costs of the project? If we know all the costs in advance and we know 100% certainty, we're going to meet budget, zero. Lead time, we know it's going to take 3 weeks. Is it definitely going to take 3 weeks? Zero, because it's going to take 3 weeks. If it takes 4 weeks, then we made a mistake. Security of supply, is the sun going to shine for the next billion years? Yes, we know for sure it is. And operational risks, well, the sun's going to operate for 24 hours a day for the next billion years, so we're okay. And here you can look and see, it says none is zero, low is one, moderate is two, high is three. And that's uncertainty and assumptions. And then risks is none is low, none is zero, low is one, moderate is two, high is three. And then there's all kinds of notes about the stuff on the left. So now if we look at the highest number here is nuclear. So nuclear power is the most risky, according to the IRP 2010, where they were thinking about installing more nuclear in South Africa. It got a 10 out of 12. The maximum score is 12, because if you have 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3 fours are 12. So nuclear gets 10 out of 12, which means nuclear is very, very risky. Okay. Cost assumptions, 3. We don't know what it's going to cost. Lead time, 3. We don't know how long it's going to take. Security of supply, well, We can get uranium, but of course, we know that there's potential problems with uranium and uranium enrichment and so on. Operational risks, well, gee, what happens if there's a meltdown? We're giving it a 3. And here you can see the notes. Actual capital costs could be significantly higher than assumed. Significant EIA delays, opposition to development. So those are the problems that, you know, if you're going to build a nuclear power station, you've got EIAs, you've got environmental impacts, you've got to check them all, got to make sure everything's okay. How are you going to look after the power station for 1,000 years after it's installed? Then the next highest is pulverized coal. And that's got a 7. So cost assumptions, 1. We think we know what's going to cost. Lead time, we have no idea how long it's going to take. Security of supply, well, South Africa's got 1,000 years of coal. And then operational risks, 3. So that gives us 7. And we look at 6. Okay. So we've got open cycle gas turbines, which is at the moment in South Africa's diesel. Cost, 3. We gave it a 3 in 2010. I mean, look at us in 2022 with the price of diesel doubling in a year. And from 2010 to 2020, the price of diesel doubled already, which means that it's just mind-blowingly exponential growth. We have no idea what it's going to cost. Lead time assumption. Well, that cost is actually the cost of building the thing. Yeah, operational risks. We say, okay, we know how to build it. Security supply, we gave it 2, which is that problem we talked about just now. And lead time assumptions, 1. So you can see we got 6. And we go down to wind. Wind gets 2 out of 12. Now, you would have thought, with all the nuclear debate, that nuclear is so much better than wind. Why is wind only got 2? Well, cost. We've got some idea what it's going to cost. Lead time, we know exactly how long it takes to build and install a wind turbine. Security of supply, well, you know, there are different kinds of supply. So the security of supply of the wind turbines, which is what they're talking about here, and then the security of supply of the wind, as long as the sun keeps shining, the earth keeps rotating, we're going to have wind. If any of those two things stop, well, life will end as we know it. So I don't think we should worry about that. Operational risk, 0. So we give it 2. And then there's no PV here. even though in 2008, the government announced, the South African government announced feed-in tariffs. So you would have thought that the IRP 2010 would have feed-in tariffs. I mean, would have photovoltaic panels with feed-in tariffs. And if you had photovoltaic panels, well, the cost would be zero because we know what the cost is. Lead time, we know what the lead time is. Security supply, we know what the security supply is. Operational risk. And I would give photovoltaic panels a zero risk. So there we are. Here we are with nuclear and coal having high risk and photovoltaic panels potentially having no risk. So this is important to understand. I know it says draft, but like I said to you before, the final version didn't contain everything in the previous versions. And somebody went to a lot of trouble to produce this chart. I think it's important that we understand it. I think it's important that we understand risks and that we deal with them and that we go forward in our usage. And yes, I still believe that coal is a part of our future for the next 10 or 15 years at least. So we should be building coal power stations that will meet our requirements and not necessarily build coal power stations for 50 years when we're going to not need coal soon. Okay, thank you very much. As always, like, subscribe, share, and look forward to your comments. Good night, goodbye, good morning.